Welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Today we'll be looking at the Boxford lathe. I've had some problems with the chuck slipping on the belt. So what we'll do is have a look at the V-belt that's in there, see what conditions it's in, and have a look at how we replace it. Okay, on the Boxford lathe, you've got this plate. I've undone the screws. We can take the cover off. And inside are the gears and the top of the pulley for the belt. This is the lever that engages the back gear. You can see here a small ball bearing. That is actually the ball bearing that pushes down when you oil the top. The oil can has to push that ball bearing down, make a seal around the aperture and pump oil inside there. Now you have to do that through the hole on the front of the machine. So if your oil can doesn't seal, you're actually pumping oil onto the top of that pulley here, and this next to it is your drive belt. So eventually your drive belt gets saturated in oil. The oil's thrown all over the inside here, and this makes the drive belt slip. Now the first job I've got to do today is give everything a good clean out and get rid of as much oil as I can from the area. I've used this cleaner and some rag to clean out all the oil from the belt area. I've split the links on the belt. As you can see, that's the belt. Each link is held together with a type of rivet. You can see from the touching it, the dirt and the oil on this, it's saturated in oil and it started to delaminate. The other thing as well is that that when the belt's in the pulley, the top of the belt is level with the pulley, so it may be that the bottom of the belt is bottoming on the pulley rather than the sides of the pulley. That belt was 45 years old at least. It was the original belt. This is a shaft with the back gear on there. There's a gear on this one which is connected to your head, your chuck. And in this gear there's some holes. This is the pulley. See if you can see that any better. This is the pulley here where the belt goes, and what we do when we change back gear, it just slides this gear along so that this one engages with that and it disconnects this gear from the drive. You might be able to see it moving backwards and forwards. This gear here is moving as well. And in this gear, move the camera a bit better position. There we go. In this gear, there's some holes, and on this shaft, there are some pins. And when the gear is in position, the pins, there's a pin there, will go into the hole. On the gear. That's back gear engaged. And that's without the back gear. Direct drive. You can see the condition of the pulley. Get the light. This is the belt, the V for the belt, and it looks as if the pulley has been just touching the bottom of the V. So that would mean even if I took some links out to tighten it up further, once it's touching the bottom, it loses traction on the side of the V. Let's check the bottom pulley. Now you can see the bottom pulley, which I've cleaned, and the pulleys on the left are to select the speed. And if you follow that down, in the bottom here you've got the right hand pulley is the drive to the motor, and the left hand pulley is for your different speeds. The new belt, it's a different design. It's got T connectors on rather than a round rivet head, so you just turn the T connector and it will go through the hole easier. It's also not leather, some sort of plasticky material reinforced, so I'm hoping it'll be quieter. And you can see the old one to the new one. The new one looks a little bit wider, even though it's supposed to be the same size. That just shows how much the old one has been reduced in size. Now let's see how this fits. The new belt, the links, go into the belt like this. Just bend the belt, push the link through. Once it's in, twist it round and it's locked. So it seems easier to undo and easier, hopefully easier to fit. Now I've taken the back cover off, give me easier access to the hole. You can see the hole at the bottom there in the lathe tray. It's got a surround round it to stop any suds getting down. So the belt has to go through that slot, up through the head here, over the pulley, down, under, into the cabinet and around the bottom pulley. As soon as you poke the belt down, it's curving round, and there's a small hole here by the bed of the lathe, and there's another hole you have to get the belt through. It's in the base of the tray. So you have to poke the belt through two holes to get down to the pulley at the bottom. So what I've done is fed through this piece of metal, which is I use for threading wires and things. So now I'll tape the belt onto the end of that with some masking tape and pull it through. Right, after some time of messing about trying to feed it through, I've actually got it fitted. I know it's loose, but at the moment I just want to run it to get it to bed itself in. You can tell it's loose because I can hold the chuck still with the motor still running. So I'll leave it for 5 minutes to settle in, then I'll take a link out. If you compare this belt with the other one, you can see that this new belt stands a lot higher in the pulley, and please note the direction of the belt links. The narrow end is facing the direction of travel. I've taken another link out, running it. I just want it to bed in really. I can't stop that chuck now on the same speed where before I could. So it's just a matter of leaving it for 10-15 minutes to bed in and slowly move the belts onto the higher speed, because with the old belt in cold weather like today, the temperature in here is 8 degrees, and I couldn't put this machine in full speed. You could hear the motor grumbling, the belt slipping, so you have to get the bearings warm, everything warmed up. At the moment it's halfway along the belt, so it's running at 540, so it's quieter than the last belt, because I haven't got all the bits flapping around. So I'll put all the guards back on and see how it goes. So this is three links I took out. Seems to have settled in okay. It's been running for half an hour. This is the old belt. You can see it's soaked in oil. Started to delaminate. But it has lasted 46 years.
Well, thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on enots Engineering.